Hi, AD. Just kidding. Hi, guys. Welcome to my home. So if you're new here, I'm Alexandra. I'm a home decor YouTuber specializing in small space renter-friendly makeovers. This is my home. I live here with my two cats, Lottie and Boo, and my partner Noah, and we are in the entryway. We live in a heritage home, which means that this house was built in like 1884, which is really cool. And it means that we have all of this beautiful molding detail. The house has a lot of character, which I love, but we've made some upgrades to it to make it feel like obviously a little bit more modern and just more functional. Like this entryway is such a weird shape. So we implemented a lot of like functional changes. This shoe cabinet I've taken with me apartment to apartment. It's been used in so many of my makeovers because it is such a functional piece of furniture if you live in a small space. We fit so many shoes in here and I made it look really custom. So I added new knobs, new paint, a wood top. It looks like a custom piece of furniture. These are actually three different Moroccan runners that I found on Etsy. They were on like a major sale. I think I bought all of these for like $300 or something crazy. And Graham and I DIY'd it so that it looks like one long continuous runner, but it's actually three. If you're new to my channel, Graham is the handyman on my team and he helps bring all of my projects to life. Okay, should we go upstairs? Let's go. I could never figure out how to make this landing functional in like any sort of way. So I just thought, let's lean into it, make it decorative. This mirror is one of my favorite pieces in our home. I love it. I have a thing with squiggles, which you will soon find out. Okay, let's head into the kitchen. This kitchen was such a labor of love. My landlords, Bri-Ty, we call them Bri-Ty, Brian and Tyler, have just been so keen to like lean into the fact that I do this as a job. And I've really been able to like experiment in ways that I wouldn't necessarily be able to do in other people's homes, like tiling both walls here. I took out all the upper cabinets on this wall to do open shelving. We painted the cabinets green and changed all the knobs. Looks like a completely different space in here, but I love it so much. The newest addition to this kitchen was installed a few months ago. It's this beautiful water filter from Sorso Wellness. I have always dreamt of having a water filter in my home and just didn't think it was possible. It just felt like a really intense process that needed to happen. But they came and installed this in under an hour. Everything fits nicely under my sink. It's also hooked up to my ice maker in my fridge, and the water tastes so great. I just wanted a moment for like all of my favorite things to be displayed. So like glassware, the plates we use every day. A lot of people ask like, doesn't your stuff get really dusty? But we use this stuff all the time. Like even the little bowls when I'm cooking, I'm using this stuff all the time. So it works for us. This little nook is one of my favorite spots to lounge in during the spring and summer with the window open. I work here a lot. And this piece is from Calm Art Studios on Etsy. Kay is such an amazing artist and she does these like beautiful 3D textured art pieces. Noah and I love her work a lot. So I love that this is in the little corner here. For Lottie and Boo's food, I actually found this like serving tray from H&M Home a long time ago. And then underneath I have this placemat here. I actually sell these in my store, Palmed Marketplace. They are handmade in Morocco and they have these little cute tassel details, but it just helps keep like the mess at bay with their food, which is great. Therapy has been a part of my weekly routine for years and has drastically changed my life, which is why I am so glad that BetterHelp is sponsoring today's video. I knew that I needed to speak to a therapist, someone who was outside of my friends and family group, when the feelings that were consuming me just felt too overwhelming to handle on my own. To me, there is nothing better than feeling validated and seen, and like my feelings aren't totally crazy or weird, that they're actually pretty normal. Therapy has made me become self-aware on a whole new level and has made me a better friend, a better partner, a better boss, because I'm able to understand why I react in the ways that I do in certain situations. BetterHelp connects you with a licensed therapist who is trained to listen and give you helpful and unbiased advice. First, you go to their site. You can use my link, betterhelp.com/gator. You answer a few questions and BetterHelp will match you to a professional who has years of experience helping people with struggles just like yours. You can do it all from your phone or computer via phone call, video chat, or messaging, however you feel the most comfortable. Let BetterHelp connect you to a therapist who can support you all from the comfort of your own home. Visit betterhelp.com/gator or choose Alexandra Gator when you sign up and enjoy a special discount on your first month. Before we get to the dining room and the living room, this is actually a house for my cat's litter box. It hides it because we have nowhere else to put it in the home. It was an IKEA cabinet and I painted it, added this cane webbing to the front. And then at the side, they have a little arch door that they walk in and out of. By the way, any project I have mentioned in this video is on my YouTube channel. So like the kitchen reno, this DIY, it's all there if you wanna go watch those. Okay, this is the dining room. I love this fireplace. It's actually original to the home. I think Brian and Tyler brought it up from downstairs, so it doesn't work. It's just here for aesthetics, but I love it, and it's just such a feature in this home. I really, really wanted the Anthropology cabinet that looks exactly like this, but it was so expensive, didn't ship to Canada. So Graham and I actually DIY'd our own using an IKEA Billy bookcase and an IKEA dresser. Noah and I use this all the time, especially when we're hosting. It's so nice just to have everything corralled in one place. And then these drawers are really small, but they actually hold so much stuff, like party supplies, tablecloths, napkins. It's all here, which is so great. This door leads out to our patio. We're not gonna go out there because it's still technically winter here in Canada, but I'll show you some shots of what it looks like in the summer. We have this beautiful tree and it flowers with these like beautiful white flowers. It's just such a moment out there in the summer. We spend a lot of time out there. And then this is the living room, probably one of my favorite rooms in our whole home. Noah and I spend a lot of time in here. And this room took a long time for me to get right. If you know, you know. I remade over this space a bunch of times. I could never figure out how to make this wall feel like a statement. So the last time I made it over, we added this peel and stick molding from Lux Architectural, and it brings that character into the space even more. Added these wall sconces. And then this TV is the frame TV by Samsung. So it's supposed to look more aesthetic than just a black box on your wall. So you can change up the art whenever you want and really customize it to your space, which I love. These kind of side tables that we've turned into somewhat of a functional coffee table are from Just Be Woodsy, and they actually take fallen Toronto trees and make them into furniture. So I love that we have like an actual piece of Toronto in our living room. This works for us instead of a coffee table because it's a really small space. So I wanted to break it up a little bit. This light has been with me for so many years. I actually was sent this when I worked at Chatelaine because we photographed it. I think it's like one of the earliest decor pieces I ever had in my possession. It's just kind of very sentimental to me, but it's also really unique and I love it. So she's not going anywhere. So when we moved in, these stairs were totally carpeted, like stair to stair, gray carpet. So I took the carpet off and then installed this new pink runner. This is Noah's office, also where I do my outfit reels. You may recognize it from Instagram. Now, this room has always been kind of like a weird in-between room. Noah doesn't work here all the time, and honestly, we just needed more storage, so it was becoming kind of like a dumping ground for just stuff until Graham and I installed these IKEA wardrobes. We MacGyvered so many pieces of IKEA furniture and got these custom doors made. It's honestly added so much storage for ski gear, luggage. I'm not gonna open the doors because they're kind of messy. This closet, which I will open because it's clean, is all of my spring and summer clothes. So like all of my off-season clothes, basically. Got all my jewelry in here. And then storage for all of our books up top. This rug is from the Jungalow, and I love the purple hues, how they like play off the green cabinets. I get so many questions about what this color is on these doors. It's Windsor Green by Benjamin Moore. This laundry closet was such a tricky project to make over because there was this weird gap beside the washer and dryer. There was no door on it. And I was kind of stumped as to what to do. I just kind of leaned into making it as functional and practical as possible. So Graham and I added shelves all the way up to the top and then one long one up there. I decanted my OxyClean into this beautiful glass jar. All my dryer balls are in here. I put my stain remover in this cute little spray bottle, and it just makes it not only look good, but for me, it's like a more enjoyable chore to do because everything looks so cute. I also never thought I would be a person to use like a curtain as a makeshift door, but I really think it works in this little particular corner. And I put the curtains on a curved rod so that you can push them all the way to the side and really get them out of the way when we're doing laundry. This is our bathroom. Now, I do not take for granted that we have basically a bathroom the size of a bedroom. I grew up with a tiny, tiny bathroom that my family of four shared. So to have all this space and storage is so lovely. Honestly, there wasn't a ton to do in this bathroom. This tile would not be my first choice, but pulling this all up and like retiling everything would be a full-on reno. So I just made like tiny aesthetic changes, like changing the lights, the mirror, changing the knobs of these cabinets, adding some cute hooks. I actually tiled over the original backsplash tile that was here, same tile as downstairs. We have a clawfoot tub original to the home as well, and just like tons and tons of storage, which I fill with no problem. Okay, last stop to my favorite room, our bedroom. I just wanted this room to like exude calmness, and I wanna have the best sleep I've ever had every single night, which I do in this bedroom because I've set it up for success. One of the things we both agreed on, both Noah and I, was that we didn't want an area rug in here. We really love the old floors, they like creak, and we just wanted to let them have their moment. This bed is from Article. I can't recommend Article furniture enough. It's just so well made and timeless and beautiful. And we have these storage drawers underneath that are also from Article for storing just extra things that we don't have any other space for. A big, big game changer in this bedroom are these blackout shades, which we didn't have here before, and I have no idea how we were getting good quality night's sleep. This Roman shade is from Two Pages, and what I love about them is that they make custom shades to fit your window, but then they also have a lot of standard sizes, and they're quite inexpensive. These are blackout curtains, and wow. Like having two blackout things just means that Noah and I sleep so deeply throughout the night. So these IKEA PAX wardrobes were here when we moved in, and recently I kind of upgraded them. I painted them and Graham and I added molding so they looked more built in. And then I found these handles on Etsy. I'll link them down below. They're such a statement. And these wardrobes now just look so custom and like really fit the vibe of this room. Thanks for coming along on this tour. And thank you to everyone who's been watching this apartment like evolve over the years. I really feel like I just have been able to experiment with different styles and really figure out like what I love in my own space. Dream apartment, what can I say? Make sure you hit that subscribe button. We have so many makeovers coming in the next few months. Studio fixes, living rooms, perhaps a cat hotel. So make sure you subscribe, turn on the bell so you get notified whenever I upload next. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, I'll see you next time. Bye. Okay, we're done. We're done.